Hi, Maria with the Amateur Crafter here. Maria, the Amateur Crafter. So I am wanting to do a couple of sublimation pieces that I've had for a while. So I'm gonna go do those with you today. Let me pop open the heat guide because I'm gonna be using some coasters that I purchased from Cricut. So let me get the heat guide open so that we can start making those settings and adjustments. For the heat guide, I just did clicked the link here. Oh, you're not seeing. Okay, there we go. I did just click the link in Design Space to get the heat guide open. I am using a heat press, not the auto press. So I'm gonna select an auto press because it's like that. The material that I'm gonna be using is going to be essentially an Infusible ink transfer sheet, but it's a sublimation sheet that I am going to go ahead and print myself. And the base material is gonna be the coaster. And yes, that's the heat pressing mat. So it's telling me 400 degrees for 200 seconds. So let me get my heat press on. So it can start heating up. I have already designed these items, so we won't do that part, but just so you know. Oh. My desk camera turned off. Let me turn it back on. Okay. Here we've got my heat press and the supplies that I'm gonna need for this project. I did get a new thing for Black Friday. I got the 13-inch Cricut paper cutter, paper trimmer. So I am going to be using this, I think. I don't know. No, actually, I'm going to have my Cricut cut it. But let me get it open just for fun. Ouch. Be careful. I just kind of got a paper cut off the bottom of the packaging for this. There we go. This goes in my recycling bin. Just in case you never notice, on the back of your paper trimmer, there's these holders for your extra blades. So I am gonna get rid of my old paper trimmer. So I'll show you what I mean here. So you just slide these over, maybe, there we go, and pop it out. So this one, the black one is the scoring wheel, and the gray one is the slicer. Anyways, there it is. Maybe I'll have to decorate it to do something like that. This is a free, this create is a free image in Design Space. Well, I guess I'll put both of those away. The next thing I need to do is turn on my heat press. You're not going to be able to see the numbers, so I'm just going to switch it on the back. Actually, there, I say it again, actually, let me push the cable down as well. Mode, my temperature and my time is set to 400 and 200. I just press the up and down arrows on my heat press. Oh, you can barely see it. Well, you're just gonna have to trust me. Do the design. Let's see what else we need. We need the stacking order, the butcher prep paper, ceramic coaster, I like to use the cardstock for blowouts, sublimation blowouts. So we should be good there. Let's go look at the design. So I have two designs here, one for square coasters and one for round coasters. I should get both of those out. So they're going to be a set of each. My square coasters are going to be these Lower Decks square coasters. We're Star Trekkies in this house. So these ones are not ceramic, so I'm going to have to go out to 143 Vinyl where I bought the square coasters and get the time and temperature for those. So I'm not going to do those ones first. I'm going to do the Pokemon coasters first. Yes, my son. A Pokemon fanatic. And he's going to get the yellow ones. While that's loading, let's go ahead and let me show you the two coasters that I've got. So here's the square ones. Oh, I closed my browser. So there they are. But these ones are cork and wood. So they are definitely going to have a different setting than these. You know what? I might as well pull them out right now while I've got them. They're going to have a different setting than the ceramic ones. And I'm just going to leave them together like that. They put the paper in there so they don't get scratched. Well, you know what? I'll just set them up. This one, it says cut along that line. So I'm going to grab my knife. Twist to get the cap off so you don't hurt yourself. Don't ask me how I know. There we go. So I did kind of scratch that one with my knife, so be careful when you do it. I thought they would have been upside down, but I've only used these round coasters. I don't know if I've used them ever. I must have got them in something. The first thing we do when we're preparing the coasters is take a lint roller and go ahead and just give them a nice roll to get all the dust and debris off of them. Okay. And while I'm here, I'm gonna put my stuff in my recycling and take care of my trash. Okay, back to these designs. So I actually flattened these designed and used a writing font to get the names on the design. And they're flattened against a circle that is the size, hopefully, of these coasters. Let's verify that. My circles are 3.5 inches. And according to the package directions, it doesn't say. So I will grab my measuring tape. And 3.5 inches is correct. So I sized them appropriately. It's been long enough that I don't recall if I did that or not. So I just wanted to check to be sure. Okay, so it should cut out these circles for me, and they should be the exact right size for my sublimation printer. So let's go ahead and do a make. These are print then cut, so my options here are going to be different. I'm going to get out my sublimation paper while I'm waiting for that. So I might be able to fit all four of these on one. I'm gonna try, and if not, then I'll just use more sublimation paper. I'm gonna move this object to the first mat and see if I can get it to fit on. Yeah. My circles might be off a little bit, but the circles might cut into each other a little bit, but I'm not gonna feel bad about that at all. In fact, I'm gonna move that up as far as I can. Because it's not gonna matter if the circles cut over each other in this case. 3.5, 7, it's gonna be close. Let me move the other one up. Click the three dots, select move object, select the first mat. It's not gonna matter if the circles cut over each other because it's white and it doesn't have any paper on it anyways. There, I knew I would get through that. It doesn't have any writing on it, so it will be just fine. But just to, let me see if I can adjust these a little bit better. Okay, I like that. Let's go ahead and click continue. And I am gonna send this to my printer because it is a print and cut design, which is sublimation. And for the sublimation, my printer is my Epson that I converted from a regular printer, a regular inkjet, to a sublimation printer. You can find all kinds of tutorials on this online. Now that I've had a sublimation printer for a year, I don't recommend that you do it unless you're going to be printing often. I didn't use mine for probably 6 to 8 months, and it caused some problems with my print quality, so I don't do that. So Epson printer, not that it matters here, because I'm gonna select it different anyways, but I am gonna select this use system dialog. The bleed won't matter in this case because it's just gonna bleed over the white, which isn't gonna matter. But I am gonna do the use system dialog. Set my sublimation printer over on my mat so that you can see what kind I'm using, not that it matters. Wrong one. I am using this Star Craft sublimation printer paper. I am using Star Craft ink as well. So I kind of feel like you should use the same brand. And that's why I don't recommend you do sublimation unless you're going to do it often, because it is a hefty investment on the front side. It's not cheap. And it looks like my program has frozen, so I'm going to select my Epson printer. I have set up my Epson print settings to automatically do mirror the design. But looking at this, let's check in the preferences and make sure. Because I always forget to mirror, so I set it up in the property settings. And I have a sublimation option as well. I have it two-sided printing is off. Color premium presentation paper matte is what they recommend for their setting sublimation printers, and quality is high. Let me look at the more options just to make sure that I have it mirrored. I do not have it mirrored. You know what? I am going to do a print preview though, because I am second triple guessing myself here. So I want to make sure I do it right. And let me go get the paper in the printer. Aha! I know why it stopped switching, because it was stuck on the print screen. So let's go back to the printed. That's funny. Send to printer. Just took me a minute to figure that out, why I couldn't switch it. But now we're gonna have to wait again. Sorry. So with sublimation, you do have to print it the opposite way a lot, like iron-on, because it's technically an iron-on. But like I said, I'm just gonna verify these. So use system dialog. I need to select my Epson. That's just habit. It doesn't matter because I select it in the next page anyways. You know what? Now that I've set this up, I'm going to mirror this in Cricut Design Space. I would have made a mistake. So avoiding mistake. Oh, look, a mistake. I am going to mirror this here in Design Space because that way the cut will know where to cut properly. If I didn't, it would cut in the wrong place because that's how these registration marks are set up. Yeah, I feel better about that. Let's go back to print again. Third try. Ooh, I smell my heat press heating up. It's at 399 degrees. It's ready. Okay, use system dialog. Oh, didn't I select that already? Let me see if the window's hiding somewhere. It is not. Maybe Design Space was just weird for a second. Weird. Weird. There we go. Okay, Epson 2800 preferences. That is not what I expected. I need this network one is how I have mine set up because I have it printing wirelessly. I need to remove that Epson ET2800 so I don't confuse myself. Okay, this sublimation is the print setting that I set up for my sublimation printer. Print presentation matte. Let's go to more options. This is not mirrored, but I do definitely want to do the print preview so I can feel better about this job before it prints. Okay, okay, and print. Let's see how the print preview does. If it works. I've never used it on this printer. And I don't hear my printer going. Okay, I just got this dialog and it does show my print as I want it. So let's go ahead and click print. Finally, okay, so my base is not a transfer sheet. to cut my sublimation paper, it's actually, I'll do medium cardstock. And I just heard my printer go, so I'm gonna pause for a minute so you don't have to wait for my printer to go. You know what? I'm actually gonna show you this too. It says that I got a notification that there's a paper jam, but it looks like that I am almost out of cyan. I'm gonna look at that and my paper jam just to be sure. I wish I had a to-go camera so I could show you my printer. Okay, it says lift up the lid, check the rollers, it's not on this side. Okay, I'm just gonna pull it back and I'm gonna flip it over and I'll just cut off the extra paper if there is any. Okay. Okay, I have cleared the paper jam. Okay, it finally recorded, or printed. So let's go ahead and get it on the mat. There are a few artifacts from my printer because I did have a paper jam, so I'm just gonna cut those out when it comes across. So there we go. And over to the Cricut. Remember, crafting mistakes are just hugs and kisses. So this is on already from before. Get it loaded. Okay, it is ready. Let's go ahead and press go. So I do want it to cut all the way through this sublimation paper. So right now what it's doing, the Cricut, is it's actually scanning these registration marks that we've got. So it's going to scan those top two right now. I hope that the ink from when I got a paper jam down here isn't going to cause problems reading the bottom registration marks. We'll know in just a minute. Okay, it's checking I have the right blade installed. And cutting, good. Should cut pretty quick since they're just circles. And I'm gonna get out my pin pan. Check to make sure it went all the way through before ejecting the mat. Yeah, I can see that it went all the way through, so we're good there. Back to my desk. And here they are. As always, flip over, pull the material away from a mat. If right here it's sort of trying to lift up a little bit or curl. So I'm gonna be really careful. I think I'll do the Jennifer Maker. I usually don't use my spatula, but Jennifer Maker swears by it for things like this. Let me get out my spatula. See, the spatula isn't even in my tools of common goods. I guess I better put it in there. Okay. And just wiggle back and forth. There we go. That way the paper doesn't curl. That's the whole point of this. That cardstock for this sublimation paper, that cardstock setting was probably a little bit too much. I can tell because I've got cut lines in my mat. So there we go. So now I just grabbed these ones. This one looks good, no extra ink. So I'm just gonna stick it right on there and tape it down. Good thing is that these are the same size, so it should be pretty close. Some people actually tape them like on all four, but I'm just gonna trust that it's right. So in all four directions, but I'm just gonna trust that it's close enough. Oh, this tape is special tape. It is heat tape. So it's tape that's specifically meant to be able to handle these high heats. It's not normal scotch tape. That won't work. That will melt and give you poor results. I am taping, there's a shiny side and a dull side. The image is going against the shiny side. Oops, I think that mule is the one with the black in it. The Mew 2. I think had the extra ink on it. I've already taped it down, and guess what? Crafting mistakes are just hugs and kisses. I'm not gonna worry about it. Since I did check the Charizard, we'll go ahead. I'm just gonna cut out that little bit right there. And there is a little bit right there and right there, but I'm not gonna worry about it. These are just for home use. They're not for gifts. They're just fun for here, so I'm not gonna feel too bad about it. Plus, just hugs and kisses for my kid. Okay. So those are done. I'm gonna set them here on my, I'm not gonna put them on my heat press yet. I'm gonna get some cardstock for my blowout paper, and I'm probably gonna need three or so pieces. I like to do cardstock instead of the butcher paper because I already have it, and it's easy to use. I'm just gonna set these in the middle. Now the heat source actually goes against the image, but let me go ahead and get, I've had blowouts on one piece of cardstock, so just in case, let me do two. I don't think I need the cardstock on the bottom of the, against the mat, but just in case. And two cardstocks on top. And I should have checked. I have this too tight for those coasters because they're so thick. So let me see if I can loosen it up a little bit. Oops, I think that's righty tighty. Let me lefty loosey. It is going already, but I don't want to lift it up in case I move my, the coasters. If you move it while it's doing the heat press, it will probably, or if you move the heat press, the coasters will have ghosting. So this should be a firm pressure, but I can't even get it down. So still loosening. Oh, I think this is the first time I've had to loosen this. I should have been counting because it didn't lock because it didn't lock, the timer didn't start. Oh well, Okay, and give it a little bit more extra pressure. There we go. Let that go. Sorry about this cable. I moved things in my office and things just don't fit as well as they used to. Actually, they fit better, I love it, but I can't handle, I can't do anything about that cable that's in the way. Okay, so that is done. I am going to go to and print my square coasters while that is heating up. Oh, I guess I could show you what I'm doing in Cricut, in Design Space. Here we go to projects. I'm gonna go to all projects and I'm gonna do my stuff, my projects. We're gonna bring open the square coasters. I'm gonna customize. I do customize even though it's ready to print. It's a habit. I'm an old user of Cricut Design Space and we weren't ever able to make it from that screen. So it's really just a habit. I probably would have less clicks if I clicked make it. Maybe not as efficient as I could be. These ones might have a harder time fitting on. Oh, and I need to go to 143 vinyl to get my heat press settings as well. Okay, those are ready. We're gonna go to make. Same thing here, flat and squares is what I did. I do reuse my cardstock if it doesn't have a blowout. So blowout meaning the ink goes more than just on the material that it's supposed to go on. Okay, let me see. It looks like I can move these. So let's see if I can get these other two on that first sheet like I did before. Try with Moopsie. Moopsie. Nope, I'm not gonna get it. Okay, my heat press is telling me I am done. So you can see right here, it is just colored. The paper has a little bit of color to it from the heat. So, but that one doesn't have a blowout on it, so I can use that cardstock again. This one does have a little bit of a blowout, so I'll make sure to use this not facing my coasters so that it's not transferred to my other coasters, my new coasters. These are hot. I have gloves. Let me get them off and get them over. Cool down. Do not touch these with your bare hands. And we're just gonna let them cool down directly. Okay. Back over here, that definitely does not fit. So we're gonna move that object back because the squares are bigger, to page 2. There we go. Get Moopsie where Moopsie should go. And continue and print. Just like before. Oops. What did I not do? Mistake. I did not mirror. Let's go ahead and get these mirrored. And mirror this guy. Okay. Now send to printer. Use system dialog. And I'm going to go through and get this printed, but I'm not going to make you sit and watch. I'll be back in a minute. I changed my mind. You can sit and watch. You know what? I'm actually going to leave this like this. And because I selected use system dialog, I think it's going to let me select the right printer anyways. Okay, I am gonna go ahead and hop to the second one and print it as well before I load those on the mat and get them cut. Okay, normally Design Space is a lot faster than this. It really is just because I have lots of things going right now. I'm recording the video, I've got 3 monitors, I've got 2 cameras, having input in to my computer. So, and my computer wasn't built for programming or YouTubing for recording video like this. So I really am pushing the limits of my computer. Just wanted to throw that out there. I work in IT for my day job, so I do know something about that. I'm gonna click back to this first page because I will feel better about that. And I'm gonna do the laser copy paper. For my print settings, I'm going to select remember the material settings so that I don't have to set it on the next page because the medium cottage sock was too much last time. While I'm waiting for those to print, I'm going to go ahead and bring open 143 vinyl and get the press settings for their square coasters. Okay, here's 143vinyl.com. I'll make that big. Oh, it looks like my YouTube page was sort of loading there. And sublimation and blanks and coasters. Okay, here's the square coasters, 4 inches by 4 inches. Those are the ones that I purchased. And heat press settings, 400 degrees for 45 seconds, 30 to 45 seconds. You can get some discoloration if you go on the higher side of the temperature. My heat press is pretty good, so I'm going to stick it right in the middle because I don't like to go at the lower temperatures. So 400 degrees, it's already set to 400 degrees, so I will put it to, I'm going to reduce the seconds on it. So let me go back to my desk. You can see that. Pressing the mode button, switching it over to time, and reducing that to about 45 seconds or 40 seconds, 37. 37 is halfway. Okay, that is selected. I knocked it again. Sorry about that. And also these are thinner, quite a bit thinner than my ceramic coasters, which are still really hot. So I'm gonna increase the pressure a little bit. Let's see how the printing is coming along. It looks like I'm done with the first page, so let's grab that one and start to mat it. I haven't played with my printer enough to know if I can reuse the sublimation. This is because of the paper jam before, this markup here. But it will be cut off when these are cut square, so I'm not gonna worry about it. Okay, over here to my Cricut. Load it. And play. Now it'll go scan that and get that going. Let me see if my other print job is done. It just finished. I'll just set this to the side. Is it done already? No, it's still scanning. Getting those registration marks. Protecting the tool. I'm gonna take a nice little drink. This time I brought my spatula instead of my pen. That did not cut all the way through. So I need to create a sublimation paper. First of all, I'm gonna press the play button again so it'll cut in the exact same spot because I did not eject the mat. So it's gonna go cut in the exact same spot first. But what this tells me is that I probably need to create a custom material for my sublimation paper that is somewhere between that medium cardstock and laser paper. Maybe we'll do that after this is done cutting. Look again. Yes. Eject that. Flip it over. This piece I don't matter anymore. Ooh. Clean that up a little bit. So it might have just been a little bit too sticky for the mat for this type of paper. I might have gotten better results had I done it on my light grip mat instead of my standard grip mat. This is an old mat because it actually says, because I wrote standard grip on it instead of Cricut writing standard grip on it. Okay, whoop. Let's get these two. There they go. That one looks really good. That one looks good as well. Over to the Cricut to load the mat. Okay. And let's wait for it to press play. So cut. There we go. Okay, while that's going, I'm going to go ahead and tape these two down. Because this, well, you know what? I'm going to do it a different way. I'm going to do it this way. And really push it on the plate. There we go. Oh, I do need to cut that one more time, so I need to press the play button before I eject it on the printer. Don't let me forget. I almost did it. Let me just check. Yeah, it didn't go all the way through. Play. So it'll cut again in the exact same spot. Okay. Yes, that worked just fine. Over here to my Cricut, or to my desk. I might be getting tired. Okay. Those look perfect. Let's get them taped on. It looks like my machine is cutting maybe a 16th to an 1/8 bigger, inch larger than or the blank is a 16th to an 1/8 shorter, smaller than the 4 inches. So I probably actually should assume that that's probably more the case than the other, than the machine being wrong. Okay. We're ready to do this. Again, my design is up towards the plate end, the hot plate on my mat. Remember this blowout? I did put it in the inside. I can't see it. I can see it through that side. I better let this one go and get another one. Just in case. Okay. That is not enough pressure at all. Let me make sure I didn't move them. And I'm going to move them up a little bit closer to the top. There. I need to put more pressure. Okay, let's see. Okay, that was really firm pressure. I had to use two hands to get it down. Oops, I never set my time to 37. I did. Well, it'll probably be done by the time I finish. Oh, it's counting down. Me pressing all of the buttons and it's counting down, as it should. I'm like, why is it counting down? Okay, I thought it was just me. That's funny. And it will beep when it's done. Yay! Okay, I'm actually opened it and okay. That's on the right. There we go. That was really warm. No blowouts this time, so I can reuse those papers. And I bet you they're going to be hot. Thanks for remembering, Maria, to put on your gloves first. There we go. And I'm going to switch off my heat press before I forget, because that's my last project tonight. I can reuse this one as well. Let's see if the first ones are dried or cold enough. They are cold enough that I can pull the tape off. And we'll do a nice little reveal. Oh, you can barely see that. Okay. Oh, a little bit. Oh, that's just the paper. I'm getting my trash piles mixed up. So the paper is just stuck. There we go. Right there. And of course, that was the ink that was on there. It's always so much fun when you do, when you actually do the reveal. It's like, yay! But that might be a little bit too bright. Let me bring that up a bit. Okay. Cute. Again, Pikachu's got a little bit of a flaw right there. I think it's just the paper. It is. Tyler! Oop, sorry. I hope that wasn't too loud for you. I want him to come and see. A little bit right there. Right there. Let's do Charizard. Again, he just has some paper on him. Excellent. Those are so much fun. Okay. These ones aren't nearly as hot. So I can actually touch them. Oh. These didn't work at all. I am going to put them back in and I think I need a lot more pressure. Well, no, they had quite a bit of pressure. Let's see if I can rescue these. They probably need more time. Okay, so that one goes on the bottom. Again, any blowouts here? No blowouts. They had plenty of pressure, so it had to be time. I'll have to remember this for the next time I order those coasters. They need more than the 40 seconds. That first one is probably not going to work out well because the design is moved, but it's probably just fine. My heat press right now, it's set for 40 seconds, I'm going to actually increase it to the 45 that they recommended. It's set for 400 degrees, but it's actually cooled down pretty significantly. So, you know what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and lock it. And let it go And then once it's ready to pop up, I'll just do it for another 45 seconds because it's time and pressure is what it wants. Move this over. Let me get my kid in here for a reveal. Oh, fun kitty. Tyler.
Yes?
Come and see these coasters and tell me what you think. Okay. That's it. 290 degrees. I better just wait.
Yes.
What do you think?
Oh, that's cool.
Do you know what coasters are used for?
Yes, drinks.
For drinks, yeah. You like those?
They're nice. Want me to take them to my room?
You can take them to your room, or you can leave one down here too for your drinks. Show Dad. Or you can leave them all together. It's up to you. I guess while that's going, I can clean up my messes.
See, Mom, you're like the difference.
Mm-hmm.
This is a mything for Pokemon. That's a legendary.
That, okay, wait. Mew is a what?
Mythful Pokemon.
Mythful?
It's like a mythical Pokemon. Here, let me see.
And Mewtwo is a what?
A legendary.
Legendary. Mew is...
a mythical.
Mythful
Pokemon.
Show me. I don't understand what you're saying. That's right. My fault that I don't understand what you're saying. Sorry. That goes in recycling.
The Pokemon is just a ball. Pokemon.
Here. Oh, special shout out to my friend.
Mythical.
See? Yes. So Mew is mythical.
Look.
Yep. And Mewtwo is legendary. Mythical. Cool.
And legendary means legendary Pokemon.
Cool. Yep. I knew about legendary because you talked about them before.
See? Now you get them.
Shout out to my friend Rhonda, who helped me out this week. My power supply for my maker was eaten by my puppy. And so... thank you, Rhonda, for saving me by letting me use your power supply. Mine is in Amazon. I think I just got a notification that it's going to come. Oh, my webcam's broken again. Anyways, I think I just got a notification from Amazon that my replacement is on the way. They've been out of stock from Cricut for apparently like 2 years, so I had to go with third party. Oh well. Okay, so my heat press finally got up to 400 and I finished it, so let me pull these off. Oops, now I want to turn off my heat press again. And I can save all of those papers. Yes. Heat press off. And here we go. Oops. Got some shadow on there. Let me fix that. There we go. Okay. Well, learn from me. Do not pull those off the other way. So even though I moved this one, it doesn't have much ghosting, which is crazy. Absolutely crazy. I'm very surprised, honestly. Oh yeah, tape. Don't pull the tape off on the cork side first. It looks like it pulled up some of my cork. There we go. These ones are a little bit yellow now. So I might have done them too long in my attempts to fix the problem. But again, these are for home use, so I don't feel bad. It's just going to be fun. So, no problems here. Peanut something or another. There we go. So that's all of the projects for tonight. We did some sublimation, and it was a lot of fun. That's it. Thanks. Bye.